So my youngest son is 10 years old today. I don't have anything funny to say. Just congrats. I can't believe it. There have been thousands and thousands of words, mostly by me, spilled over the past 7 years trying to understand what motivates Donald Trump, to grasp why he is the way he is. Much of that has been a waste, because figuring out Trump doesn't require some sort of deep psychological dig. It's actually pretty basic. He is utterly transactional. Be nice to him, and he will be nice back, as long as he believes there's something in it for him to act nicely towards you. Witness his explanation to One America News for why he decided to back celebrity TV doctor Mehmet Oz in the Republican primary for US Senate in Pennsylvania. I'll note here, Oz narrowly defeated businessman Dave McCormick in that primary. Here's Trump.
I know Oz for a long time, and he's been very nice to me over the years. And that, you know, influences you in all fairness. And I've really liked him. I've been on his show. He always treated me well. He said I'm a very healthy specimen, which I liked very much. He said if you lost a couple of pounds, that would be okay too, but that was all right.
As a presidential candidate, Trump appeared on Oz's TV show in September 2016 amid questions about a decided lack of transparency about his medical history. The New Yorker wrote this about Trump's appearance on the show, quote, "The examination consisted of Trump handing over a couple of sheets of paper that he said contained the results of tests administered by his own physician, Dr. Harold Bornstein. Bornstein, you might recall, recently wrote that if elected, Trump would be the, quote, healthiest individual ever elected to the presidency, a hilarious assertion wholly in keeping with the modesty of his patient," end quote. I'll also note here, Bornstein later told CNN that Trump had actually personally dictated that letter about his own health. Oz then, in this interview with Trump, conducted an examination in which he never laid hands on the candidate and only asked him some questions. One of those questions was how Trump stayed healthy on the campaign trail, to which Trump responded this.
Well, it's a lot of work. You know, when I'm speaking in front of 15 and 20,000 people and I'm up there using a lot of motion, I guess in its own way, it's a pretty healthy act. And I really enjoy doing it. A lot of times these rooms are very hot, like saunas. And I guess that's a form of exercise and, you know.
I mean, I'm no doctor. Sorry, Mom. But that feels, well, not right. At the end of the interview, Oz somehow proclaimed this of Trump.
If a patient of mine had these records, I'd be really happy and I'd send them on their way.
Which, what? What Oz understood way back then and what secured Trump's eventual endorsement of his Senate candidacy was this. Trump is hugely vain, particularly about his appearance. Simply put, the quickest way into Trump's good graces is to compliment him and how he looks. And as Trump showed with his recent comments, he has a long memory for the people who are nice to him. He has an even longer memory for the people who he believes have somehow crossed him. I see you, Jeff Sessions. Oz now is likely to move away from Trump somewhat in the general election as he seeks to court voters in the ideological middle in Pennsylvania in his race against Democratic nominee John Fetterman. But make no mistake here, Trump's endorsement of Oz in the primary was absolutely critical in the TV doctor's win, period. And that endorsement had absolutely zero to do with any actual policies that he held. It had everything to do with Oz A, being a celebrity, and B, having said nice things about Trump. Trump said as much in announcing his endorsement of Oz back in April. Quote, "I have known Dr. Oz for many years, as have many others, even if only through his very successful television show," said Trump, adding this. "He has lived with us through the screen and has always been popular, respected, and smart," end quote. Trump could have added, "and nice to me," to that quote, and it would have been the perfect encapsulation of how he thinks. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.